Good morning, friends. In the previous lectures, first of all, let me give my introduction. I am Shreya Trivedi from AKDMC Jamnagar, and today we will study about SEM 3 CCE 6, one of the topic that is Emma, written by Jane Austen. Okay, Emma is one of the novel which is written by one of the greatest novelist of romantic age, that is Jane Austen. In the previous lectures, we have studied about firstly the romantic age, okay, what the romantic age was all about, what was the characteristics and types of poetry which were being written, etc., etc., etc. In the last lecture, we have studied somewhat about Jane Austen. Who was she and how much popular she was? Everything is being written by Jane Austen, or we can say the works written by her. Everything we discussed in the last lecture. So from today, we will start the summary of Emma, which is there as unit 2 in your syllabus. Like all of the Jane Austen novels, Emma is a novel of courtship and social manners. As we have studied in the biography of Jane Austen, the society in which she was living, courtship, marriage, everything, society mattered a lot at that time. Okay, lagan means courtship, marriage means again the same only, lagan. And society, aa baddu bo matter kartu tu for Emma. Or we can say the girls of that time mattered a lot, all these things, okay, to them. The majority of the book focuses on the question of marriage. Who will marry whom and for what reason will they marry? Love, practicality or necessity? Majority of the book, okay, almost we can say 90% of the book focuses on the topic of marriage, okay, or question of marriage, that who will marry whom, what will be the reason, okay, will the reason be love, will the reason be practicality, or will the reason be necessity? Okay, love though you can understand, practicality means what? You have to do, there is no option for you, okay. And necessity means what? Financially you will be able to get something through marriage, so that is the necessity. Now, which will be the reason for getting married? This is the main question, okay, which is majorly dwelling in the novel Emma by Jane Austen. At the center of the narration is the title character Emma Woodhouse, okay, heiress who lives with her widowed father at their estate Hartfield. Emma is the central or title character, okay, on whom the title is been given Emma, that is Emma Woodhouse. He is the heiress of one of the estate Hartfield, which is of her widowed father, okay. Noted for her beauty and cleverness, Emma is somewhat wasted in the small village of Highbury, but takes a great deal of pride in her matchmaking skills. Okay, she is very beautiful and clever, but it is said that she had a great pride when choosing her life partner. Okay, and today also we see such situation. Okay, there are some girls who are wanting their life partner to be having all the good characteristics in him, but they don't think that is she also apt for that person. Okay, if she gets such person which she thinks that such person is there, okay, so that is the question. કે જો તમે એક સારા વ્યક્તિને પસંદ કરવા ઈચ્છો છો, એવું ઈચ્છો છો કે સારા વ્યક્તિ સાથે મારા લગ્ન થાય, તો સામે તમે પણ એટલા સારા હોવા જો. ઓકે, સો ઇટ ઇઝ સેડ ધેટ એમા વોઝ નોટ સચ. ઓકે, યુનિક અમોંગ અધર વુમન ઓફ હર એજ, શી હેઝ નો પર્ટિક્યુલર નીડ ટુ મેરી. શી ઇઝ ઇન ધ યુનિક સિચ્યુએશન ઓફ નોટ નીડિંગ હસબન્ડ ટુ સપ્લાય હર ફોર્ચ્યુન. ઓકે, બીજી જે એના સાથેની વુમન્સ હતી એ ટાઈમની, ઓકે, એ સ્ટોરીની રાધર વી કેન સે, દે ફેલ્ટ ધ નીડ ટુ ગેટ મેરીડ, ઓકે, બટ એમા વોઝ નોટ સો, ઓકે, એમા થોટ દેટ શી હેડ નો નીડ ટુ, શી હેઝ નો પર્ટિક્યુલર નીડ ટુ મેરી, ઓકે, શી ઇઝ ઇન ધ સ્ટેટ વેર they don't, she doesn't need a husband to supply a fortune to her, means she doesn't want financial help from her husband, okay, because she was having her own estate, okay, so she thinks that there is no particular need for her to get married. At the beginning of the novel, Emma's governess, Miss Taylor, has just married Mr. Weston, a wealthy man who owns Randall's a nearby estate, okay, as we have studied earlier, we can say we have seen earlier that Emma's father was a widowed father, means what, her mother had died, okay, so she was brought up by one of the governess, means Aya, in our language we can say Aya, okay, Miss Taylor, okay, now this Miss Taylor also just married to Mr. Weston, a wealthy man who owns a nearby estate named Randall's. Without Miss Taylor as a companion, Emma feels suddenly lonely and decides to adopt the orphan Harriet Smith as a prostitute. Means what? After Miss Taylor has gone, okay, or we can say she has left Miss Taylor as a companion, she suddenly feels lonely because there was no one other than Miss Taylor whom with whom she can share everything, okay, so she decides to adopt an orphan Harriet Smith. Harriet lives at a nearby boarding school and knows nothing of her parents. Now Harriet Smith is also a girl like Emma only, okay, she is living in a nearby boarding school and she doesn't know anything about her parents. Emma concludes that Harriet's father must have been a gentleman and advises the innocent Harriet in virtually all things, including her choice of society. Okay, later on Emma concludes by seeing her that her father must be a gentleman, okay, and then she encourages her, or we can say encourages her to have a thought of Emma only, okay, એની પોતાની વિચારધારા એ એની ઉપર થોપતી હતી કે તારું સોસાયટીનું સ્ટેટસ કઈ રીતે બનશે એન્ડ ઓલ દેટ, ઓકે, સો યા સો દેટ ઇનોસેન્ટ હાર્લેટ, ઓકે, એ પણ એ વાતુમાં આવી ગઈ. શી સજેસ્ટ દેટ હેરિયટ ડઝ નોટ સ્પેન્ડ એની મોર ટાઈમ વિથ ધ માર્ટિન્સ, અ લોકલ ફેમિલી ઓફ ફાર્મર્સ હુઝ સન રોબર્ટ હેઝ પેઇડ હેરિયટ મચ એટેન્શન, ઓકે, એમા ડઝન્ટ વોન્ટ્સ હર ટુ બી વિથ અ ફેમિલી ઓફ ફાર્મર હુ હેઝ અ લો સોશિયલ સ્ટેટસ, ઓકે, દેટ ધ ફેમિલી આર સેડ ટુ બી માર્ટિન્સ, ઓકે, એન્ડ હિઝ સન રોબર્ટ he paid much attention to Harriet, okay, we can say Robert had a crush on Harriet. Instead, Emma plans to play matchmaker for Harriet and Mr. Elton, the vicar of the church in Highbury. Instead of that, Emma wants, or she plays a role of matchmaker for Harriet and Mr. Elton, the vicar of church in Highbury, means એ પોતાનો પોતાનું કામ જે છે મેચમેકિંગનું કામ એ આના થ્રુ શરૂ કરવામાં ઈચ્છતી હતી કે હેરિયટ અને એક વિસાર, ચર્ચના વિસાર, મીન્સ વન ઓફ ધ પર્સન હુ હેઝ અ હાઈ સોશિયલ સ્ટેટસ, ઓકે, દેટ ઇઝ મિસ્ટર એલ્ટન હુ ઇઝ અ વિસાર ઇન ધ ચર્ચ ઇન હાઈબ્રી. The friendship between Emma and Harriet does little good for either of them, a fact which Mr. Knightley, a neighbor and old friend, immediately notices. Mr. Knightley ek ena padoshi hata, okay, and he notices that they have become a good friend. Who have become Emma and Harriet? Harriet indulges Emma's worst qualities, giving her opportunity to meddle and serving only to flatter her. Emma, in turn, fills Harriet Smith with grand pretensions that do not suit her low situation in society. Okay. Harriet je che, e Emma ni kharab qualities ma pan enu dhyan jatu tu, means what? She was adopting Emma's worst qualities also. And Emma, in turn, was forcing her to have a thinking like her only. And the thing which doesn't suits Harriet as a low-class people, Emma, intends her to think like a big social status woman, okay? When Robert Martin proposes to Harriet, she rejects him based on Emma's advice, thinking that he is too common, okay? So, Robert Martin, farmer no son che, and who was having a crush on Harriet, he proposed her, and Harriet rejected because of Emma's advice ke bhai aa bo common che tari mate, aa taru social status kai high karse nahi, so you better leave that and don't agree to his proposal. Mr. Knightley criticizes Emma's matchmaking because he views Robert Martin to be superior to Harriet, while he is respectable. She is from uncertain origins. Okay, jyare Mr. Knightley ne evu lage che ke Emma bahu khotu kare che, Emma je che e matchmaking na kari shake because Robert is very apt for Harriet. Okay, in fact, he also says that Harriet is of low class society and Robert is much more superior than her. Yes, Emma's sister Isabella and her husband Mr. John Knightley visit Highbury, and Emma uses their visit as an opportunity to reconcile with Mr. Knightley after their argument over Harriet. Yet she still believes that Mr. Elton is far more suitable prospect than Robert Martin. Okay. Now, Mr. Knightley is the husband of Emma's elder sister Isabella, okay, and once they have visit to her place, and that Emma uses their visit as an opportunity to talk with Mr. Knightley, and she says that she argues with Mr. Knightley over Harriet, and she believes that Mr. Elton is far more suitable prospect than Robert Martin. Okay, Mr. John Knightley, Isabella je Emma ni elder sister che na husband che, ek vari ena ghare gya ane tya gya etle Emma ne ek આર્ગ્યુમેન્ટ કરવાની તક મળી ગઈ. આર્ગ્યુમેન્ટ શું હતી કે રોબર્ટ જે છે એ હેરિયટ માટે સારો નથી, પણ મિસ્ટર એલ્ટન છે એ સારો છે. એટ ફર્સ્ટ એમા સીમ્સ ટુ હેવ સમ સક્સેસ ઇન હર એટેમ્પ્ટ્સ ટુ બ્રિંગ હેરિયટ એન્ડ મિસ્ટર એલ્ટન ટુગેધર. ધ થ્રી સ્પેન્ડ અ ગુડ ડીલ ઓફ લેઝર ટાઈમ ટુગેધર. And he seems receptive to all the Emma's suggestion. Okay. But he Emma, Harriet and Mr. Elton. Je Emma samjhe che ke perfect che Harriet mate, I trane saro evo time spend kare che. Okay. And Emma ne evu lage che ke aa maru suggestion je che perfect che. When Harriet is unable to attend the Weston's party on Christmas Eve, however, Mr. Elton focuses all his attention solely on Emma. જ્યારે મિસ્ટર એલ્ટન છે એ એમા તરફ આકર્ષિત થયા હતા, ઓકે, બટ એમા જે છે એ એમ સમજતી હતી કે એ હેરિયટ માટે પરફેક્ટ છે. When they travel home by carriage from the party, Mr. Elton professes his adoration for Emma and dismisses the idea that he would ever marry Harriet Smith. Okay, જ્યારે એ પાછા પોતાના ઘરે જતા હતા પાર્ટીથી, ઓકે, થ્રુ કેરિયેજ. મિસ્ટર એલ્ટન પ્રોફેસિસ ઇઝ એડોરેશન, મીન્સ વોટ, એ પોતે કહે છે કે મને તું ગમે છે એન્ડ ઓલ દેટ થિંગ્સ, ઓકે. એન્ડ એને હેરિયટ સાથે મેરેજ કરવાની કોઈ પણ ઈચ્છા નથી એવું એલ્ટન જે છે એ એમાને કહે છે. મિસ્ટર એલ્ટન ઇન્ટેન્ડ્સ ટુ મૂવ અપ ઇન સોસાયટી એન્ડ ઇઝ ઇન્ટરેસ્ટેડ ઇન એમા પ્રાઇમરીલી ફોર હર સોશિયલ સ્ટેટસ એન્ડ વેલ્થ. મિસ્ટર એલ્ટન વોઝ ઓલ્સો અ પર્સન હુ વોઝ મેઇનલી ફોકસિંગ ઓન સોશિયલ સ્ટેટસ એન્ડ હી વોન્ટેડ ટુ ગેટ મેરી ટુ એમા જસ્ટ ફોર હર સોશિયલ સ્ટેટસ એન્ડ વેલ્થ. એમા પ્રોમ્પ્ટલી રિજેક્ટ્સ મિસ્ટર એલ્ટન હુ ઇઝ હાઈલી ઓફેન્ડેડ એન્ડ પ્રોમ્પ્ટલી લીવ્સ હાઈબરી ફોર અ સ્ટે ઇન બાથ. એમા ઓલ્સો રિજેક્ટ્સ મિસ્ટર એલ્ટન એન્ડ પ્રોમ્પ્ટલી લીવ્સ હાઈબરી, ઓકે. હાઈબરી મીન્સ એના ઘરે પાછી જતી રહી, ઓકે. સો આઈ હોપ યુ આર ગેટિંગ એન્ડ વી વિલ કીપ અપ ટુ ધીસ એન્ડ વી વિલ મીટ ઇન ધ નેક્સ્ટ લેક્ચર સૂન. ટિલ દેન પ્લીઝ ગો થ્રુ વોટ વી હેવ ડન, ઓકે. એન્ડ યસ, ડોન્ટ ફર્ગેટ ટુ કમેન્ટ યોર નેમ એન્ડ રોલ નંબર ઇન ધ કમેન્ટ સેક્શન. થેન્ક યુ એન્ડ સી યુ ઇન ધ નેક્સ્ટ લેક્ચર.